Good afternoon and welcome to the live lecture session of CEC. Dear friends, today we are taking a series that is laser physics, and today's topic in this series is types of laser. To discuss this topic within studios with us, we have Dr. Sonia Bansal, who is an associate professor in YMCA University of Science and Technology, Faridabad. Dear friends, we'll continue with this topic, but before that, I would remind you that if you have any questions regarding this ongoing lecture, you can call us on our toll-free number, that is 1-800-110-430. So without wasting further time, I would welcome ma'am to the studios and request her to continue with the lecture. Welcome to the studios, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Dear students, we are talking about the laser physics, and up to now, we have discussed about many phenomena which is behind the laser, and what are the features, what are the characteristics of the laser, and all these we have discussed in the previous lectures. Now today we will discuss about the type of laser. Lasers are of many type. It depends upon its active material. Now we will start with the type of laser. What are the type of laser? Several ways to classify the different types of laser means we can differentiate the laser on the basis of material or element is used as an active medium. Means what type of medium which we are using define the type of laser. Moreover, the mode of operation means we are having the continuous wave or pulse waves, it defines the types of laser also. Some of the laser lased at continuous wavelength and some of the laser lased at pulsed wavelength. And we can classify it on the basis of other parameters of the different type of lasers, like gain of the laser medium, power delivered by the laser, efficiency or the application of laser. In this manner, by using these parameters, by using operations and by using the active material, we can differentiate the type of lasers. Now, on the basis of active material, we can define the lasers types. Now, preference to classify the laser on the basis of material used as active medium broadly divided into four categories. One is the solid laser, where we use the crystal as an active medium. Second is the gas laser, where we use the gas as an active medium for the lasing action. Liquid laser, where we use the dye or solvent to define the liquid laser, and this will lase at a particular wavelength. Last but not the least is the semiconductor laser. Semiconductor indicates that we are using the semiconductor material to get the laser light. Now we'll discuss some of the important and particular laser one by one. We start with the first type, that is the solid state laser. In the solid state laser, we define that different type of lasers are defined in the solid state laser. General lasers of the solid state are defined as ruby laser, where the active material is the ruby in this laser. NDR laser, where we active material or the solid which we are using is the NDR. ND glass, neodymium glass laser, in which neodymium is an active medium and it is introduced in the glass, and then we can get the neodymium glass laser. Other types of solid state lasers are the tunable solid state laser, in which alexandrite laser, titanium sapphire laser, colored center laser. Apart from this, another fiber lasers are also the type of the solid state laser. Erbium in the glass host is the fiber laser. Now we will discuss about the solid state laser schematic phenomena, which is used to develop the laser. Here we are seeing that in the diagram that this is a lamp power supply for the flash lamp. This part is used for the pumping scheme to take the atom from the lower state to the higher state. This is for the absorption process. Here we are having the laser rod, where we are having the active medium in this rod, and here we are having the two mirrors. One is rear mirror and another is the output mirror. Then from the output mirror we are getting the laser beam, and here it is forming cavity. Elliptical cavity focuses pump light into the laser rod. This is in between the cavity. And here we are having the active center are fixed in the crystal or a glass material. Here this laser rod where we are having the active medium and it is electrically non-conducting. An active center present in the concentration approximately 1% and also called the doped insulator lasers. The crystal atoms act as host lattice to the active center. Means we are defining a solid state laser and we are using a crystal for the lasing action. So crystal atom act as a host lattice to active centers, and crystal usually shaped into the rod. Here we see that this is the rod which is in between the two mirrors with the reflecting mirrors placed at each end. One is the rear mirror and second is the output mirror. The flash lamp, here we see this flash lamp which is linearly shaped as a pump source placed close to the laser rod, that is for the optical pumping. We already discussed about the different type of pumping. Here we are using the lamp, so we will call it as a optical pumping, and this pumping is required for the lasing action to pump the atom from ground level to the higher level. Then mirror on the both sides of the laser rod form a resonant cavity. This is a resonant cavity which is in which the amplification or the stimulated action can be take place and provide the necessary feedback to generate the laser beam and output we will get from the output mirror. Now apart from this, what are the requirement of the host material? It should be transparent so that the light can pump the atoms from ground state to the higher state. It should not absorb the light at the laser wavelength, otherwise we will not get the lasing action. Most of the excited energy ends up at a heat rather than the light. Excess heat damages the laser crystal, and crystal should have the good thermal conductivity for the lasing action. Normally cooled with the forced air or circulating the wire. To cool the atom, just pass the air or the water will be circulated in the cavity. Now active centers are ions of the metallic elements. There are the different type of material which are used for the lasing action, like chromium, neodymium, titanium, cerium, iridium, holmium and the cobalt. These are the different type of active materials which is used to lase and which is used for the lasing action. The chromium is the active center in the ruby and alexandrite laser. The chromium we can use the chromium in both the lasers as an active medium. Neodymium is an active center in the common type of solid state laser. Most of the common used element is the neodymium. Now solid state laser is very simple to maintain and capable of generation of the high peak power. First we discuss about the ruby laser. This is one type of the solid state laser in which we will define that how it is construction and how it works. Now first the ruby laser developed in the 1960 after the discovery of the laser light. The ruby laser, here this is a schematic diagram of the ruby laser. Here we see that this is the ruby rod which is the active medium rod, and here the flash lamp is surrounded by it. This flash lamp used for the pumping process, and here we are having the two mirrors. One is the two external mirrors. One is this side which is used which is for the amplification, and this mirror is the output mirror, or we can get external mirror which is partially transmitting so that light can pass from it, and the output of laser light can be achieved from this part from of the cavity. And this power supply for the flash lamp we are using, and here we see that this is the coolant to pass through the rod so that the active material can be cooled time to time to maintain the thermal conductivity. Now ruby laser rod is a synthetic ruby laser is used, which is Al2O3 doped with the chromium ions. Now, chromium ions concentration is 0.05%, which is approximately 1.6 into 10 to the power 25 ions per cubic meter. The active center where we are using the chromium ion have a set of three energy levels suitable for the lasing action. It means this is the three level laser system. The aluminium and oxygen ions are inert in this rod. The ruby crystal as cylindrical rod having the 4 cm length and 0.5 cm in the diameter. The helical photographic flash lamp here, this is a flash lamp filled with the xenon. It means for the pumping process, we are using the xenon lamp. Now, end phase ground and end face is grounded and the polished. Mostly silvered face is 100% reflection and 10% transmission. For this, we use the Fabry-Perret resonator, which is used for the both the side of the cavity. Now, system is cooled with the help of coolant circulating around the ruby laser. Here we see in the diagram that this is the pump laser which used for the pumping just to get the atom at the excited state, and this is the laser rod and external mirrors are attached here, and this is this pump lamp and the laser rod are at the focal axis. In practical laser flash lamps of helical design no longer used. Most commonly used are the linear lamp. Here we are using the xenon lamp. Laser rods placed in an elliptical cavity with a linear lamp mounted at focus of internally reflected cavity. Here we are having the internal reflected cavity to ensure an efficient transfer of the pumping energy to the ruby laser to take the atoms at the higher level. Now, here this is a energy level diagram for the of the chromium ion in the ruby laser. A three level laser system, E2 is the metastable state. Now, we will discuss this first. This is the energy level of the chromium ion in the ruby laser. This is the ground state here, and here this is which is represented by E1. This is the first excited state, which is represented by E2. This is the third excited state, which is E3, and this is E3 dash life. Here we are having that closely spaced metastable lifetime, which is having the lifetime of 3 meter second. We already discussed this is a three level system. Here this is the metastable state, which is having a longer lifetime and the atoms can stay for a longer time at this state, and it is very closely spaced, and these two are the upper levels. Here from the ground level, the atoms are pumped with the energy of or we can say the optical pumping will be done with the light of 550 nanometer from this level to the upper level. And from here, this is the 400 nanometer to take the atoms at the higher level, at the chromium level. And this type of optical pumping are used to raise the atom at the higher level. Now, we are achieving the population inversion at these levels. Now, we want the stimulated emissions. For this, we will use the metastable state. Now, the molecules from these two upper level will spontaneously emit at the level 2. From here, it is stimulated, and these transitions are non-radiative transition. As the atoms are at the metastable state E2, it will be stimulated, and from here the stimulated emission will take place, and the molecules and the atoms will come at the ground level by giving the lasing action or laser light of 694.3 nanometer. And this is the laser transition from the level 2 to from the level 1 in the three laser level system. Now, this is a 3-level laser system, and E2 is a metastable state with a lifetime of 3 milliseconds. And ruby rod irradiated with an intense white light from the xenon lamp. For the pumping, we have to use the xenon lamp. And ground state of chromium ion absorb light at pump bend of 550 nanometer. And here for the 2, it is the 400 nanometer. Now, non-radiative transition to E2 means there is a non-radiative transition from the higher upper level E3 to the lower level E2. Now, population inversion we will achieve at the level E2, because here after achieving the population inversion, the stimulated emission can take place. Now, radiative transition from E2 to E1, it will be the red fluorescent with the peak near the 494.3 nanometer, which is in the red color will falls into the infrared region, and which will be 694.3 nanometer lasing action or laser light we will achieve by the ruby laser. Under the intense excitation, pumping greater than the critical threshold value, the spontaneous fluorescent photon of the red color act as input and the triggered. The stimulated emission or the system lasers will be achieved at 694.3 nanometer. This is the phenomena of the ruby laser. Now, laser output in case of the ruby laser occurs in the form of pulse of microsecond duration. It means the output of ruby laser is in the form of the pulse light. The stimulated transition occurs faster than the rate at which the population inversion is maintained in the crystal. And once the stimulated emission commences, the metastable state E2 depopulated very rapidly. Now, again, we require to populate the metastable state E2. At the end of each pulse, population at E2 falls below and threshold value required for the sustaining emission of the light. Now, lasing cease and the laser become inactive. So, next pulse will arrive only after population inversion is achieve. When we achieve the population inversion again, then we can get the laser light. Now, the next pulse will arrive only after the population inversion is restored. This is the output illumination. This is the input illumination for the ruby laser light pulses. Then high energy storage capacity because of the long upper laser level lifetime. The pulse energy up to the 100 joule can be achieved. Relatively inefficient from 0.1 to the 1%. Variety of applications of this ruby laser, a most important one is used in the holography. Ruby laser is used in the holography. The next type of laser is ND-YAG laser. In the ND-YAG laser, the neodymium, this is the neodymium ion, which is a rare earth magnetic ion, which emission is at 1 micrometer when it is doped into a solid state host crystal, then we can get the laser light. Now, what is the solid state host crystal in which we dope the neodymium atom, and why we are, how it is possible that neodymium having the capacity to be in a to be doped into the multi-lattice system. Here we see that most commonly host material are the neodymium ion, and here in this ND-YAG, what is YAG, which is the yttrium aluminium garnet, which is represented by the YAG, it will be crystal and a glass, and this YAG with the neodymium will be called as ND-YAG laser, and this end took place in the yttrium ion. Typical doping cone is 0.72% by the weight corresponding to the 1.4 into 10 to power 26 atom per meter cube is the capacity of the doping. The typical length of Andy Yag laser is 10 centimeter in the length and 12 millimeter in the diameter. Here we see the schematic diagram of the Andy Yag laser. Again, this is the flash lamp, flash tube. Again, we are using the optical pumping in this case to pump the atom from lower state to the higher state. For this flash lamp, this is the power supply which is given to the flash lamp, and this flash lamp is very near to the Andy Yag rod, and this is closed in the ellipsoidal reflectors. And here we are having the two mirrors, mirror M1 and mirror M2. Mirror M2 used for the output of the light. Andy Yag rod and a linear flash lamp housed in a reflector cavity of elliptical shape. In practice, external mirrors, which is of the having the 100% and the 90% reflectivity, are used. The system is cooled with the water circulation to maintain the thermal conductivity. This type of laser is the four-level laser system, and in this four-level laser system, this is the ground level, and this is the first upper level, and this is the second upper laser level, and these are the highest upper level laser system. In this manner, this is having the 1, 2, 3, and 4 levels, where so that it is called as a four-level laser system. And the terminal laser sufficiently far from the ground state. Here we are having this state is the metastable state, or this is the metastable level at which we have to achieve the population inversion. Now this is the E3 is the metastable state, and the lasing action takes place between the E3 to E1. In the previous case, the lasing action took place into the level 2 to level 1. Now here the lasing action is in between the E3 and E2. Here the two pump bands are used, one at the 700 nanometer and another is the 800 nanometer. This is the optical pumping used to take the atom at the higher level. These are the absorption bands where all the atoms from the ground level go to the higher level. From here, from this level, the atoms will spontaneously emit and jump to the level E3. Which is the metastable state and having the more lifetime as compared to the other state. Now the two pump bands are used, which is the 700 nanometer and 800 nanometer. The pumping intense flash of the white light from the xenon lamp. Andy Yag ion excited to multiple energy state at E4 here. These all excited at the multiple energy state, which is E4, defined by the E4, and decay to the upper level laser, which is the E3. The population inversion readily achieved between the E3 and the E4. The stimulated to emit of light of the 1.06 micrometer laser line or 1064 nanometer laser transitions are possible in between the level 3 to level 2. And from level E2 level, NDR quickly dropped to the E1 by transferring energy to the crystal. Now from here we are getting the lasing action. All the atoms will fall upon at the E2 level. From here it is fastly or spontaneously jump to the lower level by transferring energy to the crystal, so that the population inversion can be maintained. The many other transitions occur near the IR infrared region all are weaker than the main 1064 nanometer transition. It means the laser light of 1064 nanometer is more prominent than the other light. And moreover, only the 1318 nanometer transitions produces the 20% power as that of 1064 nanometer. It is useful for the fiber optic transmission. The laser output in the form of pulses at high rate. Again, here we are getting the pulse light as an output. Overall efficiency approximately 0.1 to 1% range. Xenon lamp, flash lamp, pulse output. Tungsten halide lamp are CW output, continuous wave output. The CW output power of over the 1 kilowatt obtainable can be pumped by the diode laser for ideal pumping and efficiency, which is made of the gallium arsenide. Primarily wavelength 1064 nanometer in the IR region, possible to the double the frequency by second harmonic, and twice the frequency, half the wavelength. We will just calculate with the formula. Now adding a harmonic generator to the system, then we can get the light in the green region, which is of the 532 nanometer. Thank you.
Thanks, ma'am. Dear friends, we'll take a break here, and after a short break we will join you. But before that, I would remind you that if you have any questions regarding this ongoing lecture, you can call us on our toll free number, that is 1-800-110-430. So see you after a very short break. Stay tuned. Welcome back, friends. Today we are going with the topic types of laser. So let's start and continue with the topic. Continue, please, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Okay, we are discussing about the type of laser, and in this type of laser, we are discussing about the solid state laser. And the solid state laser, up to now, we have discussed about the ruby laser, where the active material is the chromium. And after that, we discuss about the solid state laser, which is the neodymium plus YAG, means ND-YAG laser we have defined. And here we are having that the output pulse is continuous wave. Now next is the ND-glass laser, neodymium glass laser, glass which is an excellent host material for the neodymium. The attraction for the glass is a well developed technology for making the large size glass laser with the good quality. And as we know that it is a optical, that's why we are getting the good optical quality. Now, while the ND-YAG laser can operate in the CW region, means continuous wave mode, and ND-glass laser only operate in the pulse mode because of the low thermal conductivity of the glass. It works in the pulse mode. And ND glass laser is a very high output energy per unit volume of the material. Here the active material is the neodymium plus glass. The ND glass laser material primarily used as amplifier for the large pulse laser. We are getting the very large pulse laser in the ND-YAG laser material. Now, an NOVA laser developed for the nuclear fusion by the Lawrence Livermore National Lab employed a large number of ND glass amplifier to produce a very large power of approximately 10 to the power 13 watts. What are the application of the ND glass laser is that it is widely used material processing and medical applications in the association with the optical fibers are used. It is used in the military applications and it is used in the range finding in the sea or at the sky. And this is the now next is most commonly used laser is the tunable solid state laser. If we talk about the tunable, then the one thing comes in the mind that the dye lasers are the tunable laser. But here we are talking about the tunable solid state laser and produces output over a range of wavelength. Tunable means we are getting a output over a range of wavelengths, and the very popular tunable over a range. This laser is very popular so that we can get the lasing light at in a range. And the tunability, because of existence of the cluster of vibrationally excited terminal levels near the ground state, and that is vibronic state. The dye laser, also the tunable, however, suffer from the dye degradation and other limitation. So most of the time tunable solid state laser are used because of the some limitations of the dye laser. The solid state tunable laser are unlimited self life and operational life more as compared to the dye laser. And useful application of these tunable solid state lasers are remote sensing and the spacecrafts. Here we see the energy level diagram of the typical vibronic laser and chromium ion in alexandrite crystal. Now this is the most common typical vibronic laser. Here we are having the lower vibronic bands, means we are having the various vibrational levels at the ground level and can drop to anywhere in the vibronic band. Here this is from here the atoms from the lower vibronic band to the upper excited state of vibronic band, and from upper excited state to the lower vibronic level of the excited state. Means here we see from the diagram that the atoms will jump from this lower vibronic level of the ground level to to the upper vibronic level, and from this upper vibronic level, of the excited state, the atoms will jump to the lower level of the upper vibronic state. After that, the emission will takes place, or we can say the stimulated emission can takes place, so that we can achieve the laser light from this lower upper vibronic band to the lower vibronic band. And here, and in this manner, we are having the lasing action. Now, alexandrite, which is the chromium in the BeAl2O4, from here the atoms will jump to the from the lower vibronic level to the upper vibronic level, and from the upper vibronic level, the tunable beam of the range 700 to 830 nanometer we will get. And these are the type of tunable solid state laser. Now, we will define this type of laser. Example is the alexandrite laser. This is the 3-level solid state laser, and which is similar to the ruby laser. A tunable range and the lasers in the wavelength of the range 700 to 800 nanometer. The material which is used is alexandrite, which is doped with the BeAl2O4 and with the chromium ions in the concentration of about 0.1%, with the density 3×10^25 ions per meter cube, and it is of the shape rod shape of the 10 centimeter long and 6 mm in the diameter. The pump level of is the 380 nanometer or the 630 nanometer. From here, it is very clear that we are using the flash lamp to pump the atom from ground state to the higher state, means we are using the optical pumping. And this pump level is the 380 nanometer or the 630 nanometer. Now, chromium levels in the alexandrite form a band of upper lower vibronic band, and electronic levels of chromium and the vibrational levels of the crystal lattice. Vibronic transitions can occur over a range of energies. Excite ion can drop from upper level to the lower level in the vibronic band, and this will explain the gained width. What is the gained width? When the vibrational transitions occur with a particular range of energies, and excited ions drop from upper level to the anywhere in the lower vibronic level, then we will get the gain width. It is tunable, so tunable to any desired wavelength within a emission spectrum which we require. It can operate in the pulse as well as in the continuous wave mode, and can store more energy than an equal size of ND-YAG laser. And it is widely used in the cancer therapy, kidney stone removal, and the population pollution detection. It is used for the pollution detection. And another laser is the titanium sapphire laser, which is another type of tunable laser. This is the titanium doped sapphire crystal, which is represented by the TiAl2O3, where titanium replaced some of the aluminium ions, and the doping concentration of this type of laser is 0.1% by weight. The most commonly used tunable solid state laser is the titanium sapphire laser, which is having the wavelength in the range of 660 nanometer in the red region to the 1180 in the near infrared region. And its operation is also as a pulse or the continuous mode, means output which we are getting may be the pulse or the continuous mode. Lifetime of the upper laser level too short, and it is of the 3.8 microsecond. It cannot be pumped with the flash lamp. So, the frequency doubled, ND-YAG laser for the pulse operation is used. Pump with the argon laser for the continuous wave operation. For the pulse, NDR laser used for the pulse operation. For the pumping, NDR laser is used to get the CW operation. Organ laser is used for the pumping of the atom from ground level to the higher level. Most commonly used laser, and it is used for the laser radar, range finders and the remote sensing. This is the one type of the solid state laser and the tunable laser. The next is the color centered laser. This is the broadly tunable solid state laser. Another example of the tunable solid state laser is the color center laser, which operates in the high range from 800 to 4000 nanometer. The tuning achieved using the different color center crystal in the sequence. The typically color center crystal consists of alkali halide crystal that contains the point defect known as the F center. That is called a colored center. So why it is called a color center? Because here we are using the point defects in this crystal to get the lasing action. Usually produced when the crystal irradiated with the X rays. Now here for the pumping, we are using the X rays to get the absorption. The color center remain in the crystals for the duration ranging few days to the many years. Means this remaining crystal for the duration of ranging, means we can save it for a longer time. Absorb and emit as the atoms at the defect site change its positions, and we can get the different range of light because by this colored center laser. CCL must be pumped with the other laser and maintain a very low temperature, and need for the pump lasers and the cryonic cooling limits the use of the CCL in the practical application. This is the energy level diagram of the colored center laser, which define the scheme of the F center colored center laser. Here we see that this is the ground level and this is the highest level. Again here we are using the four level, so it is a four level laser system. Now from the ground state, the atoms and molecule pump to the higher level. The energy required is the 0.5 to 1.3 micrometer. And this is basically this light we can get from the laser light, and from here to here the atoms are achieved the population inversion. Now from this level, from this fourth level to the third level, the transitions will take place, and it is a spontaneous transition which are non-radiative. And at this level, which is the third level, the transition is possible to the second level, which is the lasing transitions. And from this level to the ground level, again we are getting the non-radiative transition. It means this lasing transition is more prominent. Here we are not defining the particular wavelength, because this laser can be tuned in the range of 800 to 4000 nanometer, because it is a tunable laser. Now next is the one or another type of the solid state laser is the fiber laser. Then what is the fiber laser and what material we use in the fiber laser as an active medium is the erbium. Erbium in glass host means erbium is placed in the glass and forms a three level laser with the wavelength centered around the 1550 nanometer, and the range is 1520 to 1560 nanometer. Now the output is in the range of this optical fiber is the 1550 nanometer important operation window in OFC technology. Now pump level at 900 nanometer and 1480 nanometer. It means we are using the optical pumping to pump the atom from ground level to the higher level. This is the ground level, this is the higher level, and this is the metastable state. Again 0.98 micrometer, or we can say 980 nanometer, energy are required to pump the atom from this level to to the this level. From the upper level, which is the third level, the atoms will come to the metastable state, which is the second level, and these transitions are non-radiative transitions, or this emission is the spontaneous emission. From here, the atoms will come to the ground level by giving the laser light of the range of 1.52 to 1.56 micrometer, or the wavelength of this laser light is 1550 nanometer, or we can say that it is in the range of 1520 to 1560 nanometer. Now, FA used as an optical amplification in the DWDM technology. The highly useful in understanding the long haul of OFC links. These fiber lasers are used to transmit the signals from one place to the another place as for the internet connection. Now, another type is the gas laser. Up to now, we discuss about the solid state laser, where we use the active medium as the solid, in which we define the ruby laser, ND-YAG laser, then we define the ND-glass laser, then we define the different type of tunable laser. After that, we define the fiber laser. Now, we discuss about the gas laser. What are the gas laser? Why it is called a gas laser? Because the active medium which we are using is gas. Now, different type of gas laser here defined, and the mostly used laser and the most varied laser are the gas laser. The low power helium neon laser to the high power CO2 laser. This range comes from the low power to the high power. It operates with the rarefied gases as active medium, because we are differentiating this type of laser on the basis of active medium, and these active medium excited by the electric discharge. In the solid state laser, pumping or excitation done by the optical pumping, or we can say the light is used to excite the atom or for the optical pumping. But here in the gas laser, the operation with rarefied gases as active medium excited by the electric discharge. And the various type of gas lasers are defined here. First is the neutral atom laser, which is the helium neon laser, in which the active medium is helium and neon, which are mixed together to form the helium neon laser. Next is the ion laser, in which we have the different type of laser. One is the argon laser, krypton ion laser, helium cadmium laser, copper vapor laser, and the gold vapor laser. Apart from this, there are the molecular gas laser, in which the most commonly used laser is the carbon dioxide laser. And excimer lasers are also the different type of gas laser, in which we are used the rare gas dimers like argon, krypton and xenon. And another type in the excimer lasers, the active medium is rare gas oxides like argon oxide, krypton oxide and xenon oxide. Rare gas atoms in combination with the halide atoms, and sometimes we are having the ferrite, means ARF, KRF and XeCl, chlorine. Now, chemical lasers are, chemical lasers also the category of the gas laser, where we define the HF laser. Now, schematic diagram of the gas laser are defined here. Then what is the process behind the gas laser is defined here. This is the schematic arrangement of the gas laser, where again we are having the cavity to amplify the light. So, and we can keep the active medium in this cavity, and again we require the pump to raise the atom from lower state to the higher state. For this, I already discussed that we use the electrical pumping. So, we use a electric discharge here to pump the atom, to pump the molecules in the gas laser. Now, this is the power supply for the electric discharge for the pumping process, and this is the cavity where the gas will be filled. and again we are having the two mirrors on both the side. One is the rear mirror, which is used for the amplification, and this is the output mirror where we can get the laser beam as an output. Now in the gases, unlike crystal, energy levels of the atoms involved in the lasing action are well defined and the narrow, means we are using the broad pump bands do not exist, means in order to excite the gaseous atoms, pump sources with the sharp wavelengths are required. So optical pumping not suitable for the gas laser. Now this is a question, why we are not using the optical pumping for the gas laser, as for the gaseous atoms to excite, pump source with the sharp wavelength are required. So optical pumping is not used in the gas laser. Finding an appropriate optical source for the pumping is a very great problem. So most common method is the passing the discharge through the gas medium to pump the atom from lower state to the higher state. The gas contained in the tube with the cavity mirror. Here I define that this tube contains a gas, and these two mirrors just for the amplification so that we can achieve the stimulated emission. A high DC voltage ionizes the gas for the conduction. Means we apply the DC voltage so that the gas can be ionized and the conduction in the gas can be takes place. Electrons in the discharge transfer energy to the atom in the gas by the collision. It means electron when we discharge, then the collision will takes place in the gaseous molecules and the it will transfer the energy to each other. Now for the optical operation in the practice, the laser medium contains a mixture of two gases, means for the active medium we use the mixture of the gases, like we are defining the helium neon, where we are using the mixture of the helium of the 7:1 ratio, neon in the 1 ratio. Helium neon is a mixture of the gases are used for the active medium in the gas laser. The atoms of the kind A are initially excited by electron impact, means one is used for the population inversion, A gas used for the population inversion, B atom used for the lasing action. Means atoms of the A kind A are initially excited by the electron impact, transfer their energy to the atom of the kind B. As the atoms of A are excited to the higher level, it will transfer this energy to the atoms which are at the B, which are actual active centers. The cavity mirrors can be either inside the gas container or the outside. If inside, the output light is generally unpolarized. For outside cases, mirror placed at Brewster angle, parallel polarized light. It means for the gases, the two mirrors are placed near the cavity must be in the form of Brewster angle. The gas lasers vary widely in characteristics. In the gas laser, here again we see that these two mirrors are at the Brewster angle, and this cavity contains the mixture of two gases. Why we are using two gases? For the one, to excite the atom at the higher level. When it is excited to the higher level, it transfers its energy to the another gas molecules, and from this side it will be drop and produce the lasing action from the B gases. This is the phenomena for the gas laser. Now gas laser having the very widely in the characteristics, in which it produces the output wavelength from the ultraviolet to the far infrared region. Operation is in the pulse mode and some in the CW modes. Moreover, the output power is less than milliwatt and to over the 10 kilowatt. First gas laser was defined is the helium neon laser in the 1961 at the Bell Telephone Lab. And this was the first laser, helium neon laser, which is a gas laser defined, which contains a mixture of helium and neon. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Dear friends, this was really an informative lecture about lasers. And we at CEC are always ready with such informational and educative lectures for you. So stay tuned with us always. Thank you.